It's me. Boss man just said to put the sign up. Something about not paying her dues.
How can that be? She just kept talking nonstop with George from Jordan all night, talking about staying and living here in Old Elk Creek.
Why, are you questioning the boss man?
Pot less booze, let's get out of Dodge. She left town with George last night, and I can prove it.
Go for it, Sherlock Gnomes.
Well, you see her window? Never has she ever put the shades down and not said good morning to me.
Do you honestly believe that it's the law to not greet you in the morning?
Hey, it's the law of womanly courteousness.
Well, whatever it was, she should have just left after Sunday church like the rest of them.
Like the rest of them, Jim?
Walk with me, Jim.
There's no better men like us that know how to philosophize the woman. See, look at here, Jim. Look at all these women.
What makes you think Adam would live in Elk Creek, Missouri?
Of course he does.
Adam comes with some pilot knob. What makes you think he would come to Elk Creek for our eaves when all we have are Jenny's?
Jim, get a hold of yourself.
Pete, leave me alone.
Get this. Town population to double? Babies to blame?
Babies to blame? Doesn't it make more sense to blame the parents?
Say that again?
Well, parents have the babies. Wouldn't it make more sense to blame the parents?
Jim, shut your trap. Okay, I see your point, Jim. Next time someone says something strange to you, just let me do the talking. I've been working on the newspaper all day long.
Does this man expect change to be thrown at him?
The economy, man.
Oh, I mean, take poor Pete over there. He might be unemployed by now.
Whoopity doo da, whoopity day. I love singing my favorite songs.
Seriously, Pete? You know, Caesar once lived, you know, once had a family of its own. You know, this Caesar brought my parents together, all the way back on yonder.
The
Caesar might have been tossed by the fine Lisa Kudrow on the hit TV show Friends on NBC, weeknights at 7. I mean, Pete, what the heck?
Yeah, I guess.
Or maybe Claire down the street admired the Caesar once, and she used her corny catchphrase, "I do not want to see that."
Yeah, I guess.
Yippee-zee-doo-dah, yippee-zee-day. Oops.
Oh. Huh? Assembled and produced in Boston? What did this cost the unemployed man? I mean, Horatio, what the heck? Did the croutons once grow on fields of grain that all the president's men once admired? Oh, croutons. Is what I bleed not different than Pete? Good man. Whose croutons are these?
Well, mine, sir. Zizi, wawa, zuzu, doo-doo.
Oh, these poor people. They should be labeled more than unemployed. I mean, take poor Pete over here. Unemployed, unattractive, has nothing in life. Poor Pete can catch no break. Oh, poor Pete.
All right, fella. I've had enough of your smartness, your smartiness. Who do you take me for? Some type of clown?
Oh, my poor soul!
Sir, I'm not gonna ask again.
Why, Pete, what man are you waiting for out here?
It ain't no man.
Woman?
It ain't no woman.
Why then, Pete, who?
An angel of a woman, sir. You wouldn't understand.
Oh, the poor woman, Pete, who has to stoop low enough to you, is tougher than anyone trying to find Osama bin Laden. Anyways, Pete, how long have you been waiting out here?
Only since morning.
I'm guessing this isn't the first morning.
It is, I swear. We always have morning talks.
Pete, is this woman really worth it all?
Maybe I'm mad, mister. Maybe all this waiting will lead to her not even studding up for me.
Where's she even from?
Puxico.
Okay, Puxico. And she was mad?
She seemed pretty happy to me.
Pete, how long do men like you expect women to wait?
Will you stop your questioning if I just give you another Caesar salad?
Maybe. Alas, poor Caesar. Salad. Oh, the food that used to greet me when I would come home from prep school, eating their fruit salads. Oh, Caesar, how you would greet me when I would come home from prep school and turn on HBO, because you know it's not TV, it's HBO. Oh, Caesar, were you once in The Sopranos, the hit TV show from HBO that is on right now? Oh, Caesar, why has there been E. coli outbreaks? Oh, why, Pete, why? Oh, where has my appetite gone? Where has my smell gone? For Caesar, oh, great salad, why? Tell me something, Horatio.
Sup?
Do you think Vice President Dick Cheney would come down to Elk Creek and have one of these Caesars?
Uh-huh.
Poor man. Horatio, why not send a Caesar to Dick Cheney? No. Why not have Mr. Too Good from Missouri come down here and have one of our Caesar salads? I mean, why live a life not having a Caesar?
Oh. True, man.
Oh, great George Bush, strategery and all. Please don't invade Iraq. Maybe that's just the 2002 talk you didn't be. Who's that there? Oh. Oh, God help me.
What's going on here?
Thank you, Rick. I'm Helen Hecker. And I'm in Elk Creek, Missouri, where the town has been rocked to the core. A woman was found in a hot, unlocked vehicle, dead. Tell me, sir, did you know this woman? Can you say your name? I'm pretty confused here.
Ophelia?
Hey, that's my girl!
Too bad, so sad. And to think I actually liked her.
Who did this? Who took my sister to greener pastures? Why? Why?
Screw off, Laertes. She was Pete's girl. And you know what? She was mine also. So, go away.
You want my...
You want to see crazy? This is crazy!
Oh,
get a hold of yourselves, men!
Hamlet! Hamlet!
Nice woman. Hamlet, did you know Ophelia?
Know her? I loved her. I'm the man she escaped Elk Creek every night with to go to Paradise and Patterson. I'm the boy George from the motel. Ta-da! Laertes, don't worry. He gets like this when he's hungry.
For the love of God, have some sympathy.
You know what, Mom? And I've been hit by the love bug. And you know what? No one will understand what Ophelia and I have. And you know what? For the rest of my life, all I can do is mourn. Oh!
God, he's crazy. At least someone bury the poor girl before someone steps on her first.
I know who I am, and you know what? Boss man, do you know who you are? The dog days are over, old man, and karma is coming for you. Horatio, fetch him a Caesar. Oh, my boss life. Well, my, what is to happen to that kooky son of yours? Let us go enter the no-spin zone and see what old man Riley has been up to. this. This is the end game.
I wanna be your first string. I wanna be your A team. I wanna be your end game.